I never walk out on a check. Tell one, Kevin Brennan to try harder. Two, I'm nothing but nice about this show. I'm sorry fucking Aaron Berg is a fucking coward, and I've been coming for him the whole time.
Do you understand one? Thank you.
Let me tell you what happened. Oh, my God. It's star-studded. It's star-studded. Ladies and gentlemen, Kevin Brennan has joined the...
He's a bad boy.
...the party. Kevin Brennan.
That was the worst last show ever. That was like biblically bad. That was so bad.
That was biblically with a capital U.
Was it worse than R. Bud Dwyer's last show?
I'm like, how could it be so bad?
First of all, it was that bad.
He's like hurrying to get these guests on. Me and fucking Chrissy were here. Then Barry Ribb sat down. And
I love this bit. You want to see a picture of Frankie as a crab with a steak knife?
No, I want to see. You know, I'd like to see Aaron Berg in the studio on his last fucking day. Talk about an N-word move.
Oh, yeah.
I show up on your last day?
By the way,
I don't even work here.
I don't work here.
I'm on like intern status, and I showed up on your last fucking day.
Seriously,
where's Aaron? Did he call in?
Aaron? No, legit news guy called in.
He came in character form.
And Kumi is going to pay him for this?
Hold on, callers, and we have to get to the guests, fucking adore you too. But
you have a guest?
We have two guests.
Who are your guests?
We have fucking our boy Lucas from The Bind. Look at me finally remembering the name. And his buddy Jimmy Grundle. They're gone. You walked them.
Grundle.
Yeah, don't go far.
Bind?
You really got some big names for your last show.
Did you say stupid? Did you say Nick Bames?
How about Kevin Dombrowski? He wasn't available?
Kevin Dombrowski.
He's a big name. Long. And he...
you can imagine.
It's like...
There's a drop-off.
Star-studded. Right,
yeah, but it's 3:15. It's 3:15. Gino's apologizing to the guys. He's like, we'll get you on. So I think it's like Siegfried and Roy or somebody.
Yeah.
You know, like big names.
Yeah, big name.
The Smothers Brothers or somebody, you know?
I wish it was the Smothers Brothers.
Good one, boss.
Get rid of this motherfucker.
Good one, boss.
Memories.
We're not doing that.
Where's Aaron?
Aaron is busy finalizing Comedians of the Compound.
Brennan,
why do you have to be so hurtful?
That's the whiskey talking, everybody. Barry's. Oh, look at this guy. Brought his own beard.
That was still funny.
That was a good one.
No, where's the boss? Is the boss coming in early to christen this show goodbye or something?
No, the boss. I had some drinks with the boss the other night. That was fun. But across the street. All right.
I gotta leave.
You both have to go.
Here's what's happened of late.
Somebody took my beer.
You're the pilot, right? Or you're the co-pilot.
If you would.
And Aaron is sitting there flying the plane. He just drops dead. You have to take control of the plane.
Right.
You have to fly it and land this thing.
Right.
You get to Thursday and you're like, I think we all just go into the mountain. No.
I think we're just going to fly into
the mountain. Exhausted.
Gino's talking all of a sudden here. Pull up. Whoop, whoop. Whoop, whoop, terrain.
And you're like, I was good for 3 days.
Next on-air disasters.
you're like, I was good for 3 days.
Yeah.
Maybe we just take them all out.
Just take it out.
You know, because your girl texts you, all you said was fuck off. Because all I ever say to women is fuck off.
Uh-oh.
Why don't you keep it on topic? What are you talking about?
I know what he's talking about. I speak Gino.
Oh.
I speak fluid Gino.
So that's not fluent.
But
I was just coming in, then I'll let this guy talk to say
I like how I'm Irish and I'm not allowed to drink.
That never made any sense to me.
Would you like some whiskey?
All I'm saying is, I want to say thank you. This is great. We can't wait to move forward with it.
What is that? I just see P-R-O-P. I figure it's going to be propane. It's really what...
Good one, boss.
12, a good year for chicks.
He fucks kids.
Stop hitting me. Stop hitting me.
He does that.
Watch this. I thought your chair had the wheels.
He's so abusive.
Oh, my God. What? You see that guy with the wheelchair again at the fucking Sullivan's? Can I just eat without a gimp? Looking at me?
But he's got a high-tech one.
Yeah, so that's good.
He's got the blowy tube in it.
Yeah, but he's...
Jim Norton likes on his the blowy tube.
And he's got a lady with him, so he's doing all right. Doing
anyway, the show is great.
Is she blind like the girl in math?
Yeah.
She feels the face and goes, whoa.
Yeah.
How big does this thing get?
Yeah.
I was coming on to say thank you. It's been amazing, and I can't wait.
You should be fired after that last show.
Why what?
Oh, my God. I'm going to review it.
Review it.
Review
boss.
That last show.
Boss, please. It was so good.
Was it really good?
It really was.
I guess you weren't there.
I was there the whole time.
I heard from Kevin.
You
I go, it wasn't like.
Late.
I heard from Kevin. It wasn't like the Tonight Show with Bette Midler singing Wind Beneath My Wings.
It was not. It was not.
Remember when we
it was Robin Williams. Oh, last show. Oh, this is going to be fun.
Oh, watch Johnny.
It.
Oh, Johnny.
Oh, John, let me hand myself. I'm
watch this. Garrett was. Oh, I just got that. Garrett was there. How about we and the guys dressed like vaccines come out and dance around?
Oh, that'd be good. And there'd be a message there.
Garrett. Was that's it? Important. It was one of the top 50. I know you're gonna come up. That's why he's getting nervous talking in front of you.
Such a fucking.
No, because I get nervous because I know he's gonna come up. So I try to talk too fast, and then I stumble.
Yeah.
Was that one of the top 50 in hot waters of all time?
You got me drunk.
Number one in my book, Kevin.
Whoa! Oh, that's how I felt when he said that the slap was fake. Broke my heart, Fredo.
He broke it. Off, you know. How many people have I walked from this studio? Five?
Six.
Honey! I'll take credit for six. You walked that tranny in mourning. I'll take it.
Seven, including Aaron.
Anthony, good one, boss.
Yeah, just hit him. That's what he does.
Break his fucking glasses.
Quid pro quo, Gino. Quid pro quo.
Was it quid?
No, he does it to you because you know he's going to cut you off.
Even now, fuckhead.
All right, you gave me the shots, douchebag.
Was it quid?
Gino's like, how can I make Anthony show as bad as mine was? Let me get him drunk.
Yeah, he wants everyone to be graded on a curve.
Just be bad.
Why am I the jerk?
It was a bad day at Compound. Everybody had a bad show. Even the boss man. If you get him drunk enough.
Tell you this once.
Get me drunk enough.
I'm going to tell you this once. Our show was amazing today.
I was there.
You were on it.
I saw 45 minutes of garbage.
First of all.
Where's that Stevie Lou fucking guy?
Stevie Lou is the guy that keeps coming in there.
Asshole.
There you go.
Like he goes, you guys are the guests today, right?
Yeah.
And this fucking last.
Use the microphone, Genghis.
I believe he saved it with a phone call at the end.
Okay.
Dude, that is fucked up to even have to say, I believe he saved it. You'll never hear that term
that's in very
real
rare.
Life.
Do you think
it doesn't save a lot of things.
Oh, I love it. It is the Reverend Bob Levy. Bob Levy, everyone! And I'm not kidding. Although he calls my brother the funnier Bisconti, and he's right. Bob, talk to me and close out the last In Hot Water show.
Here's the thing, Gino. Kevin Brennan announced 2 weeks ago that he was coming for your final show and to sit in there with you. And you sit him there with the humanoids in the fucking stand. You don't have a man like Kevin Brennan come to Compound Media and treat him like that. You sit there with two guys next to you that looks like house painters from South Jersey. Kevin sitting in the audience.
Exactly the point.
I got one. As always, I will end my show with someone being much funnier than me. This is perfect. That's perfect. Bobby Levy, where are you going to be? Weren't you supposed to be in AC with the Kevin Brennan? You don't have a man like Kevin Brennan coming to your studio and talk to him like that. Weren't you supposed
Listen
to be in
to
AC?
Me. I'm going to be in Atlantic City tonight, but we're going to be at McGuire's the 29th and 30th. Me and Kevin are taking over the world because you're weak now because you lost Aaron. You're only half the man you used to be. Yeah. So pack your bags and get out, bitch. Goodbye.
Watch this. Bob, you still there?
Yeah.
Aren't you? I love him. So you think that'll boost up the views on Misery Loves
Every
Company?
Every day after your show, you think I just walk over here? I get nails and lumber and saws to patch the giant hole left in the ship. The gaping hole.
If you need to see pictures, it's a gape Gatsby.
She's going down at the bow. We need to fix her.
People are unsubscribing like Artie Lang still works here.
Artie Lang doesn't do anything half-assed except blow his nose.
I think that was from the roast,
you
right?
Want the isn't list?
Isn't an Artie nose joke like a Trump hair joke?
No. It's you really want a like, list.
He's orange. He's the orange man.
Orange guy. Oh, Artie's
if you want a list of people that have crossed me and you want to wind up in that wake, I'm there for you, buddy.
Something funny, I'll punch you right in the face.
You are set.
Oh, my God.
You should have been that ballsy with Gary Goldman, you motherfucker.
I'm a fucking coward. Don't break nothing.
Or your landlord.
Don't break nothing.
More or Lenny.
Yeah, or Lenny.
Or we could sit here all day.
No, it's a long list.
Hi, buddy.
Chris Red.
Chris Red?
I had a thing with him.
I'll tell you. Yeah, yeah. I'll tell you. That's not the color that comes to mind when I think of Chris Red.
Ah, are you right? You're right. When you're right, you're right. Yeah.
Black guys with red. Red. Red.
Not now, Chip.
Red Fox.
Welcome to the first episode of In Hot Water. We're absolutely thrilled to be here. We're going to sign our contracts today to make it official, but we don't want to waste paper and become part of the problem. So we have contractual obligations with these great people here.
Well, you know, it's serious because they made that look. Can we see the logo again? Can we just see the logo again? Because it was one thing when we sent them the logo. You know, that's all in the courting stage. But once they make this bitch, they put that in, and that's like 3D. That's graphic. That makes, I don't know about you, but looking at that makes me want to drink. But I've said that about a lot of things. I've looked at a snuff video saying looking at that makes me want
to
drink.
It's, you know, looks at the gray in his hair and says he wants to drink.
Does the gray really show up?
You're getting grayer.
Well, because my hair is getting long, so the grays are making a statement. I need to cut my hair. I just haven't.
Maybe you should cut it.
You ever do that? You go to cut your well. Bad example.
Thank you.
But remember when you had hair and a future and skin that you could see?
Skin that you could see.
Well, you know, you have all the tats. Whenever I go to, I haven't gotten around to cutting my hair because I don't have anything. Like if I have an audition coming up or something, like, all right, let me cut my hair.
Yeah.
During football season.
Why would he have an audition? He doesn't need to cut it. What's he going to do? Act in a Shakespeare play in the park?
Weep not for. I'm so tired that I can't sleep. Standing on the edge of something much too deep. Funny how it feels so much, but cannot say a word. Though we are screaming inside, oh, we can't be heard.